Let's look at a couple rules for dealing with partial derivatives. We're going to be needing to use these when we do proofs or derivations. And really there's just a couple of pretty quick rules you can use, and really just three. And those will be enough to get by in this course. I'm assuming that you already know how to take a partial derivative, but we need to work on how to manipulate them. Okay, so the first rule is that if we flip over a partial derivative, it's just equal to the reciprocal. So that's equal to the reciprocal of, so dx dy is just the reciprocal of partial y partial x. Second rule is that if we take a bunch of derivatives that have the same variables, and this is just for familiarity, let's use P, V, and T. And we were to look at the partial of pressure with respect to volume, constant temperature, and then we multiply that by the three other derivatives we could get with the same three variables. So that would be a change in volume with temperature, a constant pressure, and the change in temperature with pressure at constant volume. If we take all of those, multiply them together, they're equal to negative 1. Okay? And that's really handy when maybe the first two are named derivatives and you need the third one, you can actually put it in terms of other named derivatives. Okay? And an example of that would be if I wanted to know what the change in pressure with temperature is for some material. So imagine a constant volume. So imagine I put some mercury into a stainless steel vessel and seal it, and then I heat it up. I want to know how much the pressure goes up as I heat that up in a confined space. Well, to figure out what the value of that variable, of that partial derivative, I could just take the cyclic rule as I showed you earlier, write it out, and see if I can pick out any named derivatives that I already know. Okay, so all I'm doing is, I think you can see what I'm doing. I'm cycling everything clockwise. So I'm putting that in there. I'm bringing that out here. And I'm bringing that up. So I'm cycling everything clockwise to get from the first derivative to the second, to this other derivative. I'm going to do it again to get the third one. So the V is on the bottom, so it goes on the top. The P is on the outside, so it goes in. And the T was on the top, so it goes out here. All that's equal to negative 1. So if this is the derivative over here that I'm interested in, that would be this one over here, I can say that that is equal to, and solve for that. So we can say the partial P, partial T, a constant volume, is equal to negative 1 over these other two derivatives. So I had change in temperature with volume, constant pressure, and the change in volume with pressure, constant temperature. Okay, let's go ahead and wall this off since this is something we did earlier. Okay, so looking at this, do we recognize any of the things on the right-hand side over here? Well, we should recognize this, okay, because we know that's related to kappa, that's related to kappa, kappa t, right? Or that kappa t is just negative, I'll just write it over here. Kappa t, you might remember, is negative 1 over V, the change in volume with pressure, with constant temperature. Squeeze that in there. Okay, so if we just, we can just solve for this partial derivative over here, and we can see that that's just equal to negative kappa V. So we've got negative kappa V down here. Oh, I tried to make a multiply and it turned into a nice little thing there. Okay, so that's what that is. Okay, what about this other derivative? Well, we don't have any named derivative for partial T partial V, but we do have partial V partial T, right? That's related to the expansion coefficient alpha. And so we can say that this is the reciprocal of alpha times V. And if you're confused, just write out an expression for alpha, just like we wrote one for kappa here, and you can see that this is correct. And then we can simplify this a little bit, and so it's not a complex fraction. We can see that the derivative we're looking for, this derivative in the box over here, must be equal to simply, we can see the V's are going to cancel, so it's just going to be alpha over kappa. Okay, and that actually makes sense. Let's go ahead and put a notation on here that we're talking about alpha P and kappa T. Because if we have something that swells up a lot, but it can't expand because it's in some sort of rigid box, right? We're holding the volume constant. The amount that the pressure goes up depends on how spongy the material is. Okay, so if we have a material that swells up a lot, and it's very stiff, the pressure is really going to shoot up if we try to heat it up in a confined space. Okay, and let's move on to the third rule for manipulating partial derivatives in derivations. And that is how to take a derivative of a differential. And I'll just take a differential that you're pretty familiar with. If we have the expression du is equal to cv dt plus pi t dv, I can use that to find out, to make any derivative of u that I want. So for instance, let's say I wanted the change in internal energy with temperature. But this time I wanted it to be a constant pressure. Right? Now that is not actually a named derivative, but we could put it in terms of other named derivatives. So what we do is just take derivatives of each of these differential terms. So we do that by writing down CV, and then we have to take a derivative of this differential up here. So we take a derivative of this, we say, okay, what is the change in T with T? Well, it's 1:1. In other words, if T doubles, T doubles. And so the derivative of that is just 1. So we just have a 1 here. We don't even have to write it. All right. What about the other term? Well, now we have to take a derivative of this dv. So we're taking derivative of v with respect to t. Constant p. Okay, and we're done. And if we wanted to, we could actually convert, remember this dv dt at constant p is just going to be alpha v. So if we wanted to, we could go ahead and write that. We could say this mystery derivative that we're trying to figure out what it's equal to, it's just going to be equal to derivatives that we already know. These partial derivatives are, we can look up tabulated values of alpha and molar volume and heat capacity. Those are things we could all look up. So we could actually figure out the value of this partial derivative. Let's do one more example just so you get the hang of this. What if I asked for the change in u with p? A constant t. Well, in this case, go and look at that first term. So we've got a CV, and we've got to take a derivative of T But wait a second. We're actually saying, what if we're holding t constant? So this would be the change in t with p at constant t. Well, if we're holding t constant, there is no change in t. So this term is going to go to zero. And the next term won't, though, right? Because we're going to take a pi t. And then we have to take the derivative of v with respect to pressure. Constant temperature. Oops. And we could go ahead and abbreviate that if we wanted, right? We could say that that's equal to, well, the CV term's gone. So it would just be equal to pi t. And then this we saw earlier, this is just alpha times v. So we can relate one partial derivative in terms of other named partial derivatives. And that's a skill that I'd like you to develop. Actually, alpha is not the correct derivative, as one of you pointed out after lecture today. Alpha, I'll put that over here, alpha is equal to 1 over v change in volume with temperature at constant pressure. And that's clearly not what we're dealing with over here, right? We've got something that is a change in volume with pressure. So kappa is negative 1 over v. Note the sign difference. Change in volume with pressure at constant t. And of course, we can see that derivative, if we just multiply through by negative v, we get that derivative. So really what we want, the thing we want up here, the change in internal energy with pressure at constant temperature is just going to be equal to pi t times negative kappa v. Got a kappa, got a v, and a negative sign out here. So a little bit different from our original one. So please note that change.